Hello, Cheerios friends. How are you all? I hope you all are doing good and keeping a good health too. So, children, here's your geography teacher, Aprajita, once again in front of you with a new chapter of geography of class 7th. That is chapter number 8. And it is Life in Deserts. Registan ka jeevan. Kaisa hota hai? How is the life in deserts? Let's read about it. In this chapter, we are going to learn about the Sahara Desert, the Ladakh Desert. These two deserts. In do deserts ke baare mein hum padhenge. Now, let's begin it. A desert is a barren land where there is no or scanty rainfall. अब डेजर्ट क्या होता है, रेगिस्तान क्या होता है? एक बैरन लैंड है जहाँ पे या तो बहुत कम रेनफॉल होती है या बिल्कुल भी नहीं होती है. इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू ग्रो एनी प्लांट और वेजिटेशन. वहाँ कुछ भी उगाना बहुत मुश्किल काम होता है बिकॉज रेनफॉल इज नॉट देयर. डेजर्ट्स आर ड्राई एरियाज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड विथ स्कैंटी और नियरली नो रेनफॉल ओवर लॉन्ग पीरियड्स. वो ड्राई एरिया, सूखे इलाके हैं वो डेजर्ट्स वर्ल्ड में जहाँ पे या तो बहुत कम रेनफॉल है या बिल्कुल भी रेनफॉल नहीं होती है लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. द एवरेज रेनफॉल इन दीज एरियाज इज लेस दैन 25 सेंटीमीटर इन अ ईयर. एक ईयर में 25 सेंटीमीटर से भी कम रेनफॉल होती है डेजर्ट्स में. डेजर्ट्स आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, हॉट एंड कोल्ड. The hot deserts have high average temperature and are found in the tropical regions. Two types of deserts हैं, hot and cold. जो hot deserts होते हैं वहाँ पे जो high average temperature है वहाँ क्या होता है, वहाँ पे high average temperature होता है and वो tropical regions में पाए जाते हैं. The cold deserts are cold all the time and are found either in high altitudes of the temperate regions or in the high altitudes such as the polar region. और जो cold deserts हैं वो कहाँ मिलते हैं, high altitudes में, कहाँ के temperate region के high altitudes में या polar regions में. Due to the scarcity of water, deserts can support only sparse vegetation. बहुत कम vegetation होती है क्योंकि वहाँ पानी की कमी होती है. Thus, food and water which are essential for life आर हार्ड टू फाइंड इन डेजर्ट्स. जो खाना और पानी जो कि लाइफ का एक एसेंशियल पार्ट है, सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट है, वो ही नहीं होता है, वो डेजर्ट्स में मिलना बहुत मुश्किल होता है. मीन्स ऑफ लाइवलीहुड आर लिमिटेड एंड इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट इज स्लो. अब मीन्स ऑफ लाइवलीहुड तो वहाँ होता ही नहीं है, कुछ भी कमाने का जरिया कुछ नहीं होता है. हाउएवर इन स्पाइट ऑफ ऑल दीज डिफिकल्टीज पीपल डू लिव इन डेजर्ट्स. इतनी सारी मुश्किलों के बाद भी लोग रहते हैं इन रेगिस्तान में. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट टू डेजर्ट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स, सहारा अ हॉट डेजर्ट एंड लद्दाख अ कोल्ड डेजर्ट. अब दो डेजर्ट्स के बारे में पढ़ेंगे हम, सहारा डेजर्ट जो कि हॉट डेजर्ट है और लद्दाख डेजर्ट जो कि कोल्ड डेजर्ट है. द सहारा डेजर्ट लोकेशन क्या है, कहाँ पे है लोकेटेड ये? सहारा इज द वास्ट desert of northern Africa and the world's largest arid region. कहाँ है ये? northern Africa में सहारा desert. ये vast desert है, बहुत बड़ा desert है. It occupies most of the broad northern half of Africa. Most of कितना cover करता है ये desert? It broad northern half of Africa and covers around 90 lakh kilometers square and area only slightly less than that of United States. It extends from the Red Sea in the east to the Atlantic Ocean in the west. Red Sea east में जो Red Sea है वहाँ से लेकर Atlantic Ocean west तक ये फैला हुआ है. In the north it is bound by the Mediterranean Sea and the Atlas Mountains and in the south it merges into the savanna grasslands. Now the land. Considered as a whole, the Sahara is a rather low plateau with an uplifted center that has several mountain areas. अब Sahara में क्या है? Low plateau है और उसका center जो है वो uplifted है जहाँ की several mountains हैं. Elevations over much of the Sahara average only 300 to 450 meter above sea level. In the central mountains, a few peaks reach 3000 to 3350 meter. Except for the Nile and the Niger, which flow along the desert margins, there are no permanent rivers. Ek Nile hai aur ek Niger hai. Iske alawa aur koi permanent river nahi hai is desert mein. There are numerous wadis, desert watercourses that contain water for only a short time after heavy rains. Agar heavy rains hoti hain to kuch thoda sa pani accumulate ho jata hai, thoda sa pani ikattha ho jata hai, wo bhi bahut short time ke liye. The most familiar of the Sahara's feature is the urge, an area of dunes and drifting sand. Although widely distributed, urges occupy scarcely more than a tenth of the Sahara's total area. Sahara ke jo total area hai uska more than a tenth kya occupy karta hai, urges se occupied. Less well known than urges but covering less well known than urges but covering much more of the surface are ridges, stony plains from which all sand and other fine materials have been removed by the wind. Ab urges se zyada ridges hain, stony plains jahan se jo sari sand or fine materials hai wo wind ke dwara hata di gayi hai. Large areas of exposed bedrocks that have been worn smooth by the wind are known as hamadas. Now the climate here. Kaisa climate hota hai Sahara Desert ka? Extreme dryness is one of the Sahara's chief characteristics, except in a few of the higher mountainous areas where the average annual rainfall exceeds 15 centimeter. Extreme dryness ek Sahara ka ek main characteristic hai. Wahan charo taraf dryness hai, extreme dryness hai. Except a few of the higher mountainous, kuch higher mountainous areas hain jahan ka annual average annual rainfall jo hai wo 15 centimeters se thoda zyada hota hai. Most areas receive much less and the annual total is highly variable. Some areas may have no rain for several years and then receive brief downpour. कुछ एरिया सहारा के ऐसे हैं जहाँ पे बिल्कुल भी रेनफॉल नहीं होती है बहुत सालों तक, और कभी अगर होती है तो थोड़ा सा डाउनपोर हो जाता है. द चीफ कॉज ऑफ द सहाराज ड्राइनेस इज द नॉर्थ ईस्ट ट्रेड विंड्स. सहारा में जितनी ड्राइनेस क्यों है वो उसकी वजह केवल नॉर्थ ईस्ट ट्रेड विंड्स है, विच ब्लो टूवर्ड्स द इक्वेटर ऑल ईयर. पूरे साल वो इक्वेटर की तरफ फ्लो करती रहती. As the air moves southwards, it becomes warmer, which increases its water holding capacity and quickly absorbs any available moisture. ये जो wind बहती रहती है southward, ये warm होती चली जाती है और उसकी जो water holding capacity है ये बढ़ जाती है. उससे क्या होता है, ये जल्दी से जितना भी moisture होता है atmosphere में वो absorb कर लेती है. Under these conditions, precipitation is rare. अब इस कंडीशन में प्रेसिपिटेशन नहीं होता है. डे टाइम टेम्परेचर स्पेशली इन समर आर अमंग द हॉटेस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड. जो डे टाइम का टेम्परेचर है सहारा में वो सबसे ज़्यादा गर्म होता है पूरे वर्ल्ड सहारा का. हाइज ऑफ मोर देन 38 डिग्री सेल्सियस आर कॉमन. अजीजिया लीबिया होल्ड्स द वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड हाई टेम्परेचर ऑफ 58 डिग्री सेल्सियस. Because the air is so dry and has so few clouds, the temperature drops quickly after sunset. Lekin jaise sunset hota hai, temperature bilkul down ho jata hai. Differences of as much as 28 degrees Celsius between day and night occur regularly, and overnight freezes are common during winter. Winter mein overnight freezes common hai yahan Sahara mein. Natural vegetation and wildlife. अब यहाँ का natural vegetation और wildlife कैसा है सहारा का? Except in oases where water is relatively abundant, vegetation in the Sahara is quite sparse and widely scattered. See date palms of Sahara. कहीं कहीं डेट पाम के ट्रीज हैं. मोस्ट ऑफ द प्लांट्स फाउंड इन द सहारा पर्टिकुलरली द स्मॉल फ्लावरिंग टाइप्स हैव वेरी शैलो रूट्स एंड डिपेंड ऑन एन ओकेजनल रेनफॉल फॉर मॉइस्चर. और यहाँ पे वो छोटे छोटे फ्लावर्स के प्लांट्स मिलते हैं जिनके बहुत शैलो रूट्स होते हैं. ओकेजनली कभी अगर बारिश थोड़ी बहुत हो जाती है तो उससे वो गीले हो जाते हैं, मॉइस्चर मिलता है उनको. दे कम्प्लीट देयर ग्रोइंग साइकिल इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम आफ्टर अ रेन प्रोड्यूसिंग सीड दैट लाइ डॉर्मेंट अंडर द अंटिल द नेक्स्ट रेन. ऑफन आफ्टर अ लैप्स ऑफ सेवरल ईयर्स सम प्लांट्स स्पेशली दोज इन ऑयसिस और नियर वादीज have long roots that reach subsurface water. Such plants include date palms, इनके long roots होते हैं जो subsurface water तक पहुँच जाते हैं. Tamarisks and other trees as well as most kind of desert shrubs. इनके roots बहुत लंबे होते हैं. Now, do you know, millions of years ago, Sahara was a vast fertile plain with rivers and thick vegetation. बहुत साल पहले तक बहुत मिलियंस ऑफ ईयर्स अगो सहारा एक बहुत फर्टाइल प्लेन था और यहाँ वेजिटेशन भी बहुत थिक थी. अ नंबर ऑफ केव पेंटिंग्स हैव बीन डिस्कवर्ड इन दिस रीजन डिपिक्टिंग एनिमल्स लाइक क्रोकोडाइल एलिफेंट्स लायंस जिराफ कैटल शीप एंड गोट्स. अ चेंज इन द क्लाइमेट हैज ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड सहारा इंटू हॉट ड्राई एंड बैरन डेजर्ट दैट इज टूडे. क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन का ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन की वजह से सहारा अब hot, dry or barren desert ban gaya hai. Most of the Sahara's animal life is concentrated along the northern and southern fringes of the desert and in oases. Antelopes and gazelles are the largest animals of the Sahara. Sahara ke jo sabse bade animals hain wo hain antelopes aur gazelles. There are also hares, foxes, lizards, a few species of snakes, and numerous kinds of insects. ये सब भी सहारा डेजर्ट में मिलते हैं. Now the human activities. With few exceptions, human activities in Sahara are totally dependent on the availability of water. Water की availability के ऊपर ही human activities depend करती हैं. Only in oases where water is at or near the surface. उसे oases बोलते हैं जहाँ पानी होता है. At the surface or near the surface, can humans make a permanent home? वहीं पे वो permanent home बना सकते हैं. Oases are scattered throughout much of the Sahara. Many are situated along wadis and in the highlands, where rainfall is somewhat greater than in the rest of the desert. Some consist of small groves of palm trees. कहीं कहीं small groves of palm trees हैं. While others are dates, figs and other fruits are the leading commercial crops. Wheat, barley and a variety of vegetables are raised for local use. Local use ke liye kya kya ugaya jata hai? Wheat, barley and alag alag tarah ke vegetables. Crops are grown mainly by irrigation. There are also many nomads who spend part of the year in the desert and the remainder either in the mountains or in the oases. अब नोमैड्स जो होते हैं वो क्या करते हैं, थोड़ा सा पार्ट साल का तो वो डेजर्ट में बिताते हैं और बाकी का वो या तो माउंटेन्स में चले जाते हैं या ओएसिस में रहते हैं. दे लिव चीफली बाई हर्डिंग शीप गोट्स एंड कैमल्स एंड बाई ट्रेडिंग बिटवीन ओएसिस एंड द सिटीज ऑन द डेजर्ट फ्रिज. नाउ मिनरल्स. द सहारा इज डेवलपिंग एज अ मेजर सोर्स ऑफ ऑयल गैस एंड मेटल ओर्स. The petroleum fields of Algeria, Libya and Tunisia linked by pipeline to several Mediterranean ports are important producers of oil and gas. यहाँ से Algeria, Libya, Tunisia से क्या होता है, oil and gas का ये producers हैं in oil and gas. Iron ore, manganese and copper are the chief metals mined in the Sahara. Phosphate is exported in large amount from Morocco. Morocco से phosphate large amount में export किया जाता है. Now the transportation. Many of the problems of extracting the Sahara's resources lie in the difficulty of the terrain itself and the expense of building and maintaining adequate transport routes. यहाँ transport routes में बहुत ज़्यादा खर्चा होता है अगर ऐसा कुछ transport route बनाया जाए. No railway penetrates more than a short distance into the desert and only a few roads make the crossing from north to south. Roads bhi bahut kam hain, railway tracks bhi nahi hain. Trucks and buses are being used increasingly for long distance hauling. Although the traditional camel caravans are still used. Trucks aur buses ka use kiya jata hai long distance jaane ke liye aur jo traditional camel caravan hai wo abhi tak use hota hai. The people. Most of the inhabitants of the Sahara are Arab, Berber and black. Generally, the northern Sahara has a greater share of Caucasoid people represented by the Arabs and Berbers. Increasing number of Negroids people occur to the south. Negroids, south mein milte hain. The Tuaregs, nomads of Berber origin and Bedouins are the most populous and widespread of the groups who live in the desert. Is desert mein ye sab log rehte hain. Now, the Ladakh desert, the cold desert. Abhi tak humne hot desert ke baare mein padha, ab hum padhenge cold desert, which is the Ladakh desert. Location. Ladakh is situated in the eastern part of the state of Jammu and Kashmir in India. India ke Jammu Kashmir ke eastern part mein hai Ladakh. It lies to the north of the Greater Himalayas. Greater Himalayas ke north mein hai. It is bounded by the Karakoram Range in the north and the Zaskar Mountains in the south. Now, how's the land here in the Ladakh Desert? The most striking features of landscape in this region are the high mountains and the aridity. Because of its barrenness, Ladakh is often referred to as the moon land or the broken moon. K2 Mount Godwin Austin, the world's second highest mountain peak, lies in the Karakoram Range. Karakoram Range mein kya hai K2, the jo ki world's highest mountain peak hai. The Ladakh Range has no major peaks. Ladakh Range mein koi major peak nahi hai. And its average height is about 6,000 meters. There are few passes which are about 4,800 meters high above the sea level. Fine children, important passes among them are Zarjila Pass, the Khardungla Pass. Ye do major passes. Several rivers flow through Ladakh, Indus being the most important among them. Indus River, sabse important river hai Ladakh mein. The rivers from deep valleys and gorges. Several glaciers are found in Ladakh, for example, Gangri Glacier. Now, how's the climate of Ladakh? Ladakh is situated at a high altitude and at a great distance from the sea. Sea se bahut zyada distance pe, high altitude pe hai. It therefore has an extremely cold and dry climate. Wahan ka climate bahut cold aur dry hai. And receives most of its precipitation in the form of snow. Wahan precipitation rain ke form mein na hoke, snow ke form mein hota hai. During summers, the days are warm with the sun shining very brightly and the nights are cool. Raat thandi hoti hai, din garm hoti hai. During winter, it is severely cold. Aur winters mein bahut zyada thand hoti hai. Ladakh lies in the rain shadow area of the Himalayas. The southwest monsoon winds upon reaching the Himalayas cause a lot of rainfall on its southern slopes. When these winds cross the mountains and reach Ladakh, aur ye wind jab mountains cross karke Ladakh tak pahunchti hai, there is no moisture left in them. Usme moisture khatam ho jata hai. And thus rainfall in Ladakh is almost negligible. Wahan rainfall bahut kam hoti hai, negligible hai. During winter, however, there is heavy snowfall in this region. Rainfall nahi hoti hai, lekin winters mein heavy snowfall hota hai. Natural vegetation and wildlife. The vegetation of Ladakh is sparse due to the harsh climate. Harsh climate hai yahan pe, isliye yahan pe bahut kam vegetation hai. The grasses and shrubs growing on the mountain slopes provide scanty pastures which support grazing animals. Aur jo grasses aur shrubs iske mountain ke slopes pe ugte hain wo just pastures ke liye होते हैं, उनके ग्रेज करने के लिए. सम स्टंटेड ट्रीज लाइक विलो, सिप्रस, एन Juniper and poplar are found in the valleys and the lower slopes of the mountains. Lower slope, mountain के lower slopes में ये सब trees मिलते हैं. Several species of birds are sighted in Ladakh. अब लद्दाख में कुछ birds के भी species पाए जाते हैं. कौन से हैं वो? Robins, red starks, Tibetan snowcock, raven and hawk are common. Some of these are migratory birds. अब कुछ birds जो हैं इनमें से वो migratory birds हैं. The animals of Ladakh are Tibetan antelopes, ये हैं animals, wild goats, sheep, yaks and Tibetan wild ass called kyang. Now what are the human activities here in Ladakh? In spite of the harsh climate, during the short summer season, May to August, May से लेके August तक summer season होता है, short summer season, the Ladakh people are busy in agricultural activities. इस time पे Ladakh में रहने वाले लोग क्या होते हैं? Busy हो जाते हैं किसमें? Agricultural activities में. Wheat, barley, vegetables and fruits like apples, apricots, walnuts and grapes are grown. इस time पे ये सब चीज़ें उगाई जाती. In winter, the extremely cold weather does not permit agriculture. क्योंकि winters में बहुत ज़्यादा ठंड होने की वजह से agriculture नहीं होती है यहाँ. During this time, the people engage themselves in handicrafts like weaving and carpet making. अब winters में क्या करते हैं लोग? Agriculture तो नहीं कर पाते हैं, तो वो अपने आप को किस में engage करते हैं? Weaving में और carpet making में. On the slopes of the mountains, there are alpine pastures where sheep, goats and some other animals are reared. The yak is an important animal found here. यहाँ का जो सबसे important animal है वो है yak. Apart from being a beast of burden, it provides the people with milk, meat and wool. Beast of burden क्यों कहा गया yak को? It's a very big animal और उसके खाने पीने के लिए भी बहुत सारी चीज़ें चाहिए होती हैं. तो ये इतना बड़ा बीस तो है, लेकिन ये लोगों को वहाँ के क्या प्रोवाइड करवाता है? मिल्क प्रोवाइड कराता है, मीट प्रोवाइड करता है और वूल प्रोवाइड करता है. पश्मीना, अ वैल्यूएबल फाइबर ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द सॉफ्ट अंडरकोट ऑफ द कश्मीर गोट इज यूज्ड इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फाइन वुलन टेक्सटाइल्स. फाइन, नाउ द पीपल ऑफ लद्दाख. लद्दाख इज स्पार्सली पॉपुलेटेड एज द नेचुरल कंडीशंस आर नॉट आइडियल फॉर ह्यूमन हैबिटेशन. बहुत कम लोग रहते हैं वहाँ. Tibetan Buddhism is the most popular religion practiced by the local people. जो local लोग हैं वो क्या follow करते हैं? Tibetan Buddhism. They speak the Ladakhi language. Ladakh has a number of Buddhist monasteries called Gampas. Women of this region are very hard working. Women जो हैं यहाँ की बहुत hard working होती हैं. They work not only in the house and fields but also manage small business and shops. Leh, the capital of Ladakh. Ladakh ka capital kya hai? Leh. Is well connected by road and air. Ye air aur roadway se well connected hai. Tourism is an important economic activity in Ladakh. Ladakh tourism ke liye bahut, it is an important economic activity Ladakh ka. The stark mountainous landscape attracts many tourists. The life of people of Ladakh is undergoing change due to modernization. अब modernization के चलते क्या हो रहा है यहाँ जो लद्दाख के लोग हैं उनका उनकी जो life है उसमें बहुत सारे changes आ रहे हैं. The government has undertaken a number of measures to improve the living conditions of the people of Ladakh. और government ने भी बहुत सारे measures लिए हैं इनके जो लद्दाख में जो लोग रहते हैं इनकी रहना वहाँ का improve करने के लिए. Fine, इनके living को improve करने के. Now children, here's the glossary, means the word meanings, just go through them. And quick review of the chapter, the Sahara Desert of Africa is the largest hot desert in the world. Bedouins and Tuaregs are the main nomadic tribes of Sahara Desert. The flora and fauna in the Sahara Desert is not diverse due to the extremely hot and arid climate. Agriculture and cattle rearing are the main occupations of the people of Ladakh. Now children, let's answer. Darken the circle of correct option in the OMR sheet. The Sahara Desert is located in, where is the Sahara Desert, children? Just now we have read Africa, Asia, Australia, Antarctica. It is located in Africa. The capital of Ladakh is Dras, Kargil, Leh, Mount Abu. The capital of Ladakh is Leh. Let's move further. Now, the next one is Dash is a saltwater lake in Ladakh. Pangong Tso, Nubra, Suru, Shayok. It's the Pangong Tso. Dash is found in Ladakh. Yak, camel, bison, polar bear. Ladakh mein kya milta hai? Kon hai Ladakh mein? Yak is found in Ladakh. River Dash flows through the region of Ladakh. Kaun sa river flow karti hai? Bias, Chenab, Indus, Ganga. The Indus River flows. Now, fill in the blanks. Kiang, Torex, Roots, Josila, Arab, Bedonis. Desert plants have long dash for reaching the water table and acquiring moisture. Kya hote hain desert plants mein long? Roots. So, write down roots here. Now, children, the next one is Tibetan wild ass called Dash is found in Ladakh. Tibetan wild ass ko kya bolte hain? It's known as Kiang. So write down Kiang here. Dash and Dash are two important nomadic tribes of the Sahara Desert, the Tuaregs and the Arab Bedouins. So write down Tuaregs and Arab Bedouins. Fine. Dash Pass is the major route to reach Ladakh. Josila Pass. It's Josila Pass. Now say if the given statement is true, T, or false, F. The river Nile and Niger keep the Sahara region green. Do they keep it green? No, false. There is no greenery in Sahara. There are huge sand dunes in the Sahara Desert. Yes, true. People living near oases lead a settled life in the Sahara Desert. Yes, true. Pashmina wool is obtained from camel. No, this is false. Now let's do some question answers here, children. What? Answer the following questions. What is the source of water for agriculture in Ladakh? The source of water for agriculture in Ladakh is the melting snow and the glaciers. Now, what is responsible for the economy of Sahara? Natural resources such as oil, natural gas and minerals are responsible for the economy of Sahara. Why are means of livelihood limited in the deserts? The means of livelihood are very limited in the deserts due to the harsh environmental conditions. And next is, what are the main economic activities of the people of Ladakh? So, some few economic activities of people of Ladakh are the agriculture, animal husbandry, tourism, handicrafts and trades. And the last one is, explain, tourism is an important occupation in Ladakh. As we have just now read in the chapter, abhi humne chapter mein padha, Ladakh ke baare mein, wahan tourism ko kyun tourism itna important occupation hai. So just go through the topic there again, read about Ladakh again and you will find out why tourism is important. And then explain and write it down here. Okay, children, so here we end up with our chapter, and today in this chapter we have come to know about two deserts, one hot desert, the Sahara Desert, and one cold desert, the Ladakh Desert. So I hope you all enjoyed the chapter and we'll meet again with a new chapter. Till then, stay tuned for the new video and keep blessed, keep learning also. Yes, learning is very necessary, so keep learning. And bye.